Hello guys, welcome to Pharma Gyan. This is Venkatesh and today we are going to learn previous disease outbreaks and how they were handled. So the first one is Spanish flu 1918. The 1918 influenza pandemic was the deadliest pandemic in the recent history. It was caused by the H1N1 virus with the genes of avian origin. It is also referred as Spanish flu. Nearly 500 million people, or one-third of the world population, become infected with this virus. This was the same period when the World War I is taking place. The overcrowding and global troop movement helped the 1918 flu spread. So number of deaths are 15 million deaths worldwide. Mortality rate was very high. So control efforts that were taken at that time. There was no vaccine to protect against the influenza at that time, and no antibiotics to treat infections associated with influenza infections. So non-pharmaceutical interventions taken at that time: isolation, quarantine, good personal hygiene, use of disinfectants, limitations of public gatherings. Second one, swine flu, H1N1 flu virus. It was started in the US in 2009. Initially, it was believed that only those who were in close contact with pigs have had the infection, but later it is revealed that it can spread in community. On 11 June 2009, WHO declared swine flu as pandemic. So for this outbreak, control measures were quarantine, use of masks, closure of schools and public places, use of medicines, for example antivirals, for example oseltamivir. Mass vaccination programs were done in the US. Nowadays, vaccine is available for swine flu. One shot of vaccine per year is recommended now. Third one is Ebola virus. Ebola virus is a deadly virus caused by deadly disease caused by virus. It is not contagious as more common viruses like cold, influenza. So how it spreads? It spreads to people by contact with skin or bodily fluids of an infected animals or fruit bat. Then it moves from person to person in the same way. First Ebola virus disease outbreak occurred in remote villages in Central Africa near tropical rainforests. The 2014 and 2016 outbreaks in the West Africa was the largest and most complex outbreaks. So how they were controlled? There is no prevention or treatment for Ebola, but simple interventions early on can significantly improve chances of survival. This includes fluids and body salts, which were given orally or intravenously, and treatment of specific symptoms such as low blood pressure, vomiting, diarrhea, and infections. Second one is hand hygiene. It is the most effective way to prevent the Ebola virus. And there is an experimental vaccine which is proved highly effective against the deadly virus in major trials in Guinea. Fourth one, SARS, S-A-R-S coronavirus, severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus. So SARS coronavirus was identified in 2003. This outbreak was started in Guangdong province of southern China in 2002. It was not pandemic, it was epidemic. So control measures that were taken at that time: implementation of appropriate infection control practices brought the global outbreak to end. So five basic principles of infection control. First one, hand hygiene. Second, PPE, personal protection equipments. Third one, injection safety. Fourth one, environmental cleaning. Fifth one, respiratory hygiene. And transmission-based precautions, for example, contact, droplet, or airborne. So fifth one, MERS. What is MERS? Middle East Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus. It was first identified in Saudi Arabia in 2012. It is a zoonotic virus. Humans are infected through direct or indirect contact with infected camels. So human-to-human virus does not pass easily from person to person unless there is a close contact. So control measures that were taken at that time: no vaccine or specific treatment. Treatment is supportive and based on the patient's clinical conditions. So that means, guys, treatment is symptomatic. Second one is hand hygiene, same as infection control practices. So as we have seen, that most of the outbreaks are controlled or end by hand hygiene, social distancing, quarantine. I want to tell you that these things are not new for us. The whole purpose of making this video is to create awareness. I want to tell you that we have survived so far and so many outbreaks. We can survive this too by taking proper precautions advised by government. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Subscribe us on YouTube. Follow us on Instagram @pharmagan. Thank you, guys.